So of course the eight that remain go straight on. It's not a break. They don't have a cup of tea and then come back. It's straight in for that difficult routine again. But the scores go to zero, so there's no carryover of score. They perform in reverse order. So you very quickly have to get your emotions back into check from the huge delight of having made the final. Now you can see them start to try and focus so that they can perform well in the final. They just do the very difficult routine again.
There we are. As Chris says, it's reverse order. Moronina, who qualified eighth, is first up, and Hey Wenna, who qualified first, is eighth up. So China, one and two, and Tatiana Piacena has done very well to come third, to split the Chinese and the Canadians. But this will be some final from scratch.
And it was at this stage yesterday when a fair few of the men succumbed, didn't they, Mitch? And didn't finish their routines. Perhaps tried to pack a little bit too much difficulty in. I mean, it is the moment where you do have to perform your most difficult routine. There's no moment of playing safe. I guess most of them will perform the same routine as they've just done, although they do have the freedom to change it. In the previous two routines, they put two elements of difficulty in routine one, and those two elements couldn't be used in routine two. So they're free to put them anywhere they want now, so we could see the routines change slightly. Difficulty maybe be lifted a little bit.
Well, there they are. Superb. Acrobatic athletes, honed and toned, and they've made an Olympic final. Nina, she was surprised to make it, but she'll make the most of it. Savannah Vincent from the United States. Eva Golovina, some discomfort at one stage for Georgia. Darren Coburn, she's got a chance to make history. Rosie Maclennan. In the 30 plus club and using every ounce of that experience. Then the superb Chinese, the best smile of these games, of Huang Shanshan. So what a final is in store. We were thrilled yesterday, Chris, and I'm sure we're going to be enthralled and thrilled today.
We were indeed. It's so instant, this format now. No margin for error. And I think because of that, the pressure sort of pushes the gymnast slightly on the edge. Wouldn't you say that, Mitch?
Absolutely. This is absolute precision. It's about precision. Keep your focus. I've said it yesterday, I make no excuses for saying it again. It's like 10 meter consecutive dives from the high ball. Just imagine that. With no time to towel down in between them. This is instant mental focus and reaction. At the moment, a final warm up.
Yes, just a quick touch of the apparatus allowed. Two or three bounces. Just to feel the trampoline again.
We both enjoy our gymnastics, Chris, but the 2 hours flies by, doesn't it? I mean, it really is nail-biting stuff.
It is, and very intense from the word go, really. And really no room back if you make an error, is there? Within the artistic disciplines, you know, for the men with six, the women with four, if you make a mistake, you can claw your way back. But really, in this discipline, it's very instant. There's no way back, is there, from a mistake.
No, indeed. And, you really have my total respect and admiration. Technical excellence, courage, aesthetically beautiful. It is one sport to be admired.
And although very disappointing for Cat Driscoll not to make this top eight, and it would have been a great achievement for her, the British women trampolinists are very successful at the moment. They actually are the reigning European team champions. Of course, here at the Olympics, it's not a team competition. It's only an individual competition, but we've got very good depth on the women's side of the sport in Great Britain. And had it been a team competition, we very probably could have been fighting for medals. We had two more gymnasts very close to qualifying. Laura Gallagher was just less than 0.1 from qualifying, and Emma Smith less than 0.3 from qualification. So you can see just how healthy the sport is, and I'm sure it's only a matter of time before we see them break into the top of the Olympic section as well.
Now I wonder. Small problem, Golovina.
She was certainly limited in that routine, wasn't she?
Well, she was at 12.9 difficulty. Now, this is a gymnast who can get up towards 15. So,
yeah.
You know, she did play it safe. Now, perhaps the brakes really will come off in this final now she's made it.
I mean, there were two who posted difficulty scores or tariffs of 15. So a 12.9 really was way down. And she did really only get this spot on the back of the first routine and her execution score.
2 30-year-old pluses in this final, and that says a lot for the sport. If you keep yourself in good condition, train hard, longevity is your reward.
Well, it's a sport where performance knowledge is paramount, isn't it? You do have to be in good physical shape, you have to be strong, but the important thing is to learn and know how to do the skills. And of course, it's like riding a bike, driving a car. They're things that once you've learned go into that long-term memory. So as long as you keep yourself fit, you will be able to do these moves. And you see both these gymnasts here, a touch of mental rehearsal. You can see them eyes closed, going through the moves, visualizing themselves performing those moves, because they won't think their way through the performance. They will just let their body take over.
And to have the courage and confidence to let your body take over means thousands of routines in rehearsal. The neurological pathways have to be established. And Victoria Moranina stands by. It'll be the first of these eight finalists. Experience will tell us that you can take nothing for granted. Mm-hmm. The margin for error is infinitesimal. And Voronina, first to go. Victoria Moranina from Russia, first of eight, bidding for a medal. She took a long bounce in. First routine, but she's okay this time. Pike drift, double tap kick out. Another trip, tuck trip this time. She's travelling, she's got to work and she's off. And see how quickly the coach threw that mat in. He could sense danger. That's brilliant spotting. And so unfortunate for Voronina. But once that travel starts, it's from one end of the bed to the other.
Yes, he watched carefully. As soon as she took off, he knew that that mat was going to have to come in. And she was a bit unsettled, wasn't she, right from the beginning. Really, in it comes, gets it down before she lands. Bit untidy all the way round.
Well, it is, as we've said so often, a hair-raising spot. And there's no margin for error. But Anina's disappointed, so she should be. 21.915.
Judges only give you a score for the moves that landed back on the trampoline, so the difficulty is low. The air time's low.
Savannah Vincent, who was a little bit shell-shocked to get into this final. She looked twice at the score, but she's here. Stuff from her. She is taking advantage and enjoying the moment. Well done, Savannah Vincent. You made this final and you enjoyed it.
Well, that was a good routine for me. She's finished the routine bouncing higher than she started, which always means you've maintained your height throughout, which is one of the requirements. She travelled a bit, but it was a real workmanlike performance, keeping her eyes on the bed, making sure she knew where she was in the air at all times.
That was a lovely shot in the air. Such an impression of flying.
Well, that is exactly what she's doing, isn't she? Flying high. If you've got no head for heights, this is not a sport for you.
Savannah Vincent taking full advantage of the moment. A bit of a surprise, but 54.965. That's the lead. And don't write it off, because anything goes at this level.
Absolutely. And we can see this gymnast certainly step it up. Only a 12.9 in qualification for difficulty. Of course, the routine one put her into this final, where it's mostly based on execution. But now it's just the second difficult routine.
Luba Golovina. Now let's see what she does in the first of her 10 bounces. She played very safe. I'm sure she's carrying an injury. 12.9 difficulty, got her into this one. So what do we expect? And she's nicely in position. The arms are in, she's off. Pike drift, double pike, lovely kick out. Rudy outpiked very nicely so far. And this was much more the difficulty we expected. She opened with a triff and she's going well now. Finishes with full in, full out. Double twist and double straight, and that is more like we expected to see.
That was a very different routine, wasn't it? She struggled a bit and she certainly looks like she's suffering. So maybe the slightly easier routine was something she chose. Yes, that thigh looks problematic, doesn't it? She obviously went for the easier routine to make the final, and then went for broke here. She travelled around a bit. She was playing a bit dangerously on the edge here, but lovely shapes. She holds the body round the hip area so flat that when she goes into that straight shape, it's such an impressive shape. Dead straight.
Wow. Now, is that pain or relief? It's a bit of both.
I think there's a fair bit of pain.
If you can say such a thing, it was worth it. It's a 2.925. She's in second. So she's given much more of an indication that she didn't spend that long in the air there. Snatched takeoffs. So the first of the Canadian threat, and it comes from Karen Coburn. And every aficionado of this sport will want to see her get into a medal position. Unbelievable achievement. Four games, four medals. That's what she's after. Lovely pipe drift. Half in, half out. Tuck drift. Great start. Keep your focus. Rudy out. Half in, Rudy out. Full in, full out. Now that was a very good routine from Karen Coburn. Look at the smile.
Absolutely thrilled. Fourth Olympics.
31 years of age. What an athlete.
Well, she'll need a massive score if she's going to make the gold medal that she hasn't got in her collection. But it was certainly a strong challenge. Super control in those tuck positions, holds the front of the knees to be able to hold the tuck in. Kicks out so well, doesn't she? Out. Control the exit.
Gold was not the name of the game, but Christy. I don't think it's on, but what a career she's had. 55.86. Don't write her off. First at the moment. That means that everyone else has to hit, and they have to hit really, really impressively. And we are standing so far with four down. Coburn out in front. Savannah Vincent very surprised to be in second at this stage. And then Rosie Maclennan. Karen Coburn herself has said that Rosie will be an Olympic champion. I wonder if this can be her year. She's got two very strong challenges in front. And the European champion, but let's see. Rosie Maclennan.
Well, these are the top four qualifiers coming to the bed now. They start from scratch. There's no carryover score. But so, theoretically, they should be the best.
So, Rosie Maclennan. Drifts in the locker, that's for sure. Two triples. And the arms are in. There's the first, piped. Lovely half in, half out pipe. There's the second. Rolls around in the twisting elements. Very, very clean. And look at the kick out from the double pipe. Full in, full out. Control the outbounce. And Rosie Maclennan to a roar of appreciation from the audience. Has really put in a strong, strong challenge for a medal.
Those first half a dozen bounces did not deviate at all from the centre of the trampoline, from the cross in the middle. She just moved a bit as she got a little more weary in the last third of the routine, but that was really precise work.
Beautiful.
Really strong. Each time you can see right over the center. When the gymnasts are doing these multiple tuck somersaults, they hold onto those legs so tightly to control gravity. See the different use of the arms, brings them in, brings them out like a parachute to stop the twist.
She has got a massive score, I can tell you. It's 57.305, and that's the highest voluntary score so far. So, Rosie Maclennan is in pole position, and Karen Coburn, her teammate, is in second. And look how pleased she is for her.
And difficulty of 15.4. The next nearest is 14.8. So that was hugely much more difficult than the previous routines.
Tatiana Pietrania, European champion. She was in third place coming into this final, but it's a different ball game now. She really has to hit it, and she's got to hit it with difficulty and accuracy. Rosie Maclennan out in first, Karen Coburn in second, Savannah Vincent from USA in third. Jenia, triple, double, triple. And that is the sort of work you need if you're going to live with them, and she's controlling the travel very well indeed, the European champion. Double pike kick out. This is very, very impressive indeed. And she finished with a double tap, and normally she'd be full in, full out, so that would be interesting. She doesn't look too pleased, so she'd be down on difficulty.
Well, she certainly didn't finish with a huge smile, and that looks a rather subdued coach and gymnast there. So I think you were probably right, Mitch. She's got to get into the 15s to be competitive. And she was well offline on those, wasn't she? Out into that side of the trampoline. A little bit ragged around the knees at some points.
You don't want to finish a routine at this quality with a double
no.
tap. They all finished full in, full out normally. So she'll be down on difficulty. The smile isn't there. What she went through. 14.4 difficulty, 55.67. She's gone in the third, but it's Canada 1 and 2.
Well, that is significant because she had looked very, very impressive. Came into this final in third place. So now Canada. Well, Rosie Maclennan knows she has a medal.
And
only
look at
two
that.
Gymnasts
just look at
to
that.
Go.
That is what you call camaraderie. Coburn congratulates Maclennan. They are as one.
And two gymnasts from China left. They have absolutely, for the last 10 years, been dominant in this sport. Didn't compete at all until 1999. Were world champions by 2005, and I think Mitch still are, is that right?
Oh yeah, I mean, Wang Shanshan, when she hit her first world title, everyone knew China was here to stay. They got better and better and more consistent. And with two of them here, ranking 1 and 2 into this final. Rosie knows she's got a bronze, Rosie Maclennan. Wang Shanshan is known for blowing out under top pressure. I just hope for her sake, she's hugely popular, and she's away. Pike drift. Very nice work. There's the second drift. Double pike kick out. She's way in control. Rudy out. There's the feeling full out to finish, and she maintained her focus. She went through, and there's that lovely smile. Huang Shanshan.
Well, she certainly didn't succumb to the pressure today.
So, one performance remaining, and that was a challenge for the lead from Huang Shanshan, but easy score, 57.305, is no easy ask.
No, that's a very big score, very big difficulty. So, but this was lovely work. Always looks in control. Didn't allow the pressure to upset her at all. Just so extended in the straight body shape.
It's a big challenge, but I have a funny feeling. Look at that smile. Give her a gold for that.
Well, absolutely delighted. She knew it was a big, strong challenge, but she knows it's got to be good.
56.73. Second place with a difficulty of 15. And Rosie Maclennan, the prediction of Karen Coburn might well come true.
Well, that is a big upset. The whatever happens, the two Chinese gymnasts are going to be split. And that is a bit of a turnaround.
Wang Shanshan beat her in the Asian Games, pushed her to second. But at the World Championships in Birmingham last year, she was superb. And always that little characteristic blow on the hands before launching into what will be something incredible. Slightly more consistent she's been than Huang Shanshan over the years. Hey Wenna, in her bid to take gold, it's Rosie Maclennan in pole position at the moment.
And really fighting to be totally focused here, not allow herself to be distracted by the occasion.
Big, big test ahead. Last to perform. And needs a score of 57.305. It's got to be difficult and it's got to be accurate. Arms are in, she's away. Pike drift. Double tuck kick out, set up the second drift. That's spot on. Keeping the height. Tight half out. Half in, half out. Rolls out in the audio. This is good stuff. Full in, full out.
Oh.
And she's lost the outbounds. So that is a real upset. Hey Wenna has broken concentration. And Rosie Maclennan, according to the prediction of Karen Coburn, has got her gold medal. That is incredible.
Well, whoever would have thought it after all the difficult work to just lose it on that very final outbounce.
She snatched her final skill, and look at this, look. Huang Shanshan is still smiling at everyone, but that last full in, full out was snatched, her legs buckled a little bit, and it paid her back when she came out of it and couldn't control the outbounce. It is, but she's, look, she's taken it. Very well, let's have a look at the routine, and you can see it buckled a takeoff, and there's no way she could control that outbounce.
No.
Woo-woo.
The hips were behind the feet, but what a surprise. You felt the routine was finished. All she had to do was bounce up straight and back to her feet.
So now we have confirmation, 55.95. She's gone into third, and Rosie Maclennan is the Olympic champion. Huang Shanshan takes the silver, and Hey Wenna has to be satisfied with bronze. And look at those scenes. Those two are inseparable in training. They're at the same club, they've got the same terrific coach. They're looking to see, yes, it is true, I am Olympic champion.
And I think there was just a tinge of sadness that Karen Coben hadn't got the bronze as well. But what an achievement for both gymnast and coach, Mitch.
Brilliant. Dave Ross has done it again. He's had a silver and bronze at the Olympics. Silver also in the men's. And now he's got himself a gold, all from the same club. Canada have every right to celebrate. That is unbelievable. It's terrific work. And Rosie has promised this for such a long while. And now victory in London at the Olympic Games is hers.
Well, disappointment as well for the Chinese camp. Really, well, they came into this final in first and second place, and they would have expected to hang on to it, and they leave in second and third. We always knew it was going to be a fight between the Canadians and the Chinese, but I don't think anybody predicted that it was going to be a Canada victory.
Except for Karen Coben.
Absolutely, yeah. But she really did come out fighting, didn't she, Rosie Maclennan? She really gave it her all. She went for the most difficult routine, quite a bit more difficult than anyone else's. 15.4, the next one 15, and those were, there were only two routines in the 15s in this competition. So, you know, she did the difficulty. She actually had the top execution score as well, which of course is the name of the game.
From Rosie Maclennan, and she's still celebrating with Karen, and quietly under control now. But a word about Dave Ross, to coach at that level so consistently. Confirmation. Rosannah Maclennan, to give her a full name, is the Olympic champion. Huang Shanshan takes silver, a winner takes the third, and Karen Coben in a fourth Olympics misses out. Look at the margin on a bronze. She was fourth. Tatiana Krichena crumbled under the pressure to take fifth. Savannah Vincent surprised to take sixth. And Bolivina and Boronina were seventh.